Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and today we will see how to convert a delta network into the star network. So in this video, first of all we will see what is delta network and the star network. After that we will see how to convert a delta network into the star network using a very simple trick. Then after we will derive the expression for the delta to star conversion. And in the end, using one example, we will understand that how this delta to star conversion is useful in solving the circuit problems. So let's first of all understand what is delta and the star network. So if you see any delta network, in the delta network the circuit elements are connected in a such a way that they form the shape of a triangle or a delta. So that is why this kind of networks are known as a delta network. So in this network, if you see, this node A, B and C are the nodes of this network, while the resistors RAB, RAC and RBC are connected between these three nodes. Similarly, if you see a star network, in the star network the circuit elements are connected in a such a way that they form a shape of a star. Also, if you see this network upside down, it looks like a shape of a Y. So that is why sometimes this network is also known as a Y network. Now suppose in any electrical circuit, if you see a pi network, then this pi network can be easily rearranged into the delta network. So if we simply rearrange this pi network, then it can be easily converted into the equivalent delta network. And on this pi network, we can apply all the conversion rules which are applicable for this delta network. Similarly, in any electrical circuit, if you see this T network, then this T network can be easily rearranged into the star network. So simply by rearranging this T network, we can convert it into this equivalent star network. So all the conversion rules which are applicable for this star network are applicable for this T network. So now as we know that what is delta network and the star network, now let's convert this delta network into the equivalent star network. So if you see here, these resistors RAB, RAC and RBC are the part of this delta network, and we want to convert this delta network into the equivalent star network. So the first step for the conversion is draw this star network into this delta network. So if we draw this star network into the delta network, it will look like this. Now if you see here, this resistor RAB and RAC are adjacent to this resistor RA. So we can write the expression for RA as RAB into RAC divided by the total resistance, that is a RAB plus RBC plus RAC. So we can write the expression for RA as multiplication of the adjacent resistors divided by the total resistance of this delta network. Similarly, we can write the expression for RB as RAB into RBC, which are the adjacent resistor to this resistor RB, divided by the total resistance of this delta network, that is RAB plus RBC plus RAC. And similarly, we can write the expression for RC. So RC can be written as multiplication of resistance RAC and RBC, that is RAC into RBC divided by the total resistance, that is RAB plus RBC plus RAC. So in this way we can convert any delta network into the equivalent star network. So the formula is just multiply the adjacent resistors and divide it by the total resistance of the delta network. So now let's just derive these expressions. So now before we start this derivation, here we have assumed that this delta network and the equivalent star network are not connected to the any other network. That means this node A, B and C are open circuited. So now the resistance between this node A and B can be given as resistance RAB in parallel with the series combination of this resistor RAC and RBC, that is RAC plus RBC. Or we can write the equivalent resistance between this node A and B as RAB into RAC plus RBC divided by the summation of all the resistors, that is RAB plus RAC plus RBC. Now in the equivalent Y network, if you see, the resistance between this node A and B can be given as summation of this resistor RA plus RB. As this node C is open circuited, so no current will flow through this circuit. So the equivalent resistance between this node A and B will be the summation of this resistance RA plus RB. Let us say this is the equation number 1. Similarly, the resistance between this node B and C will be the RBC in parallel with the series combination of RAB plus RAC. That is, RBC in parallel with the series combination of RAB plus RAC. Or we can write it as a RBC into RAB plus RAC divided by the total resistance, that is RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Now in the equivalent Y network, the resistance between this node B and C can be given as summation of this resistor RB and RC, that is RB plus RC. Let us say this is the equation number 2. Likewise, the resistance between this node A and C can be given as RAC in parallel with the series combination of RAB plus RBC, that is RAC into RAB plus RBC divided by the summation of all the resistor, that is RAB plus RBC plus RAC. And in the equivalent Y network, the resistance between this node A and C will be the summation of this resistor RA and RC, that is RA plus RC. And let us say this is the equation number 3. So here we got a 3 equations. So now let's just add these 3 equations. So adding these 3 equations, we can write 2 into RA plus RB plus RC is equal to 2 times RAB into RBC plus RBC into RAC plus RAC into RAB divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Or we can write it as a RA plus RB plus RC is equal to RAB into RBC plus RBC into RAC plus RAC into RAB divided by the RAB plus RBC plus RCA. And let us say this is the equation number 4. So here we got these 4 equations. So now one by one, let's just subtract this equation 1, 2 and 3 from this equation number 4. So subtracting equation number 1 from this equation number 4, we will get the expression for this RC. So we can write the expression for RC as RAC into RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Similarly, subtracting this equation number 2 from this equation number 4, we will get a expression for this resistor RA. So resistance RA can be given as RAB into RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. And similarly, subtracting this equation number 3 from this equation number 4, we will get an expression for this resistor RB. So resistance RB can be given as RAB into RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. So in this way, we got a 3 expressions for this delta to star conversion. So now suppose in this delta network, all the 3 resistors are same, then in the equivalent star network, the value of the resistance RA will be R into R divided by R plus R plus R, that is R square divided by 3R, which is equal to R by 3. Similarly, we will get the expression for RB as R by 3 and RC as R by 3. So in the delta network, if all the 3 resistors are of same value, then in the equivalent star network, the value of these resistors are 1/3 of the original value. That means in the delta network, the value of all resistors is R, then in the equivalent star network, the value of each resistor will be the R by 3. So now let's just see one example, and using this example, let's understand that how this delta to star conversion is useful in solving the circuit problems. So here we have given one circuit, and in this circuit, we need to find the equivalent resistance between this node A and B. So if you see this circuit is neither in series combination nor in a parallel combination. But if you see this circuit contains a two delta network. The first delta network consists these three resistors, that is 40 ohm, 60 ohm and the 100 ohm. And the second delta network consists these three resistors, 100 ohm, 90 ohm and the 100 ohm. So we will convert one of this delta network into the star network. So in this example, we will convert this first delta network into the equivalent star network. So let us say in the equivalent star network, the value of these resistors are RA, RB and RC. So RA can be given as multiplication of this 40 ohm and 60 ohm resistors divided by the total resistance, that is 200 ohm. So the value of this resistance RA will come out as a 12 ohm. Similarly, this resistance RB can be given as multiplication of this 40 ohm and 100 ohm resistors divided by the total resistance, that is 200 ohm. So the value of this resistor RB will be 20 ohm. And likewise, the value of this resistance RC can be given as multiplication of this 60 and 100 ohm resistors divided by the total resistance. So the value of this RC will come out to be a 30 ohm. So in this way, we got a value of this resistance RA as 12 ohm, RB as 20 ohm and RC as a 30 ohm. So we can replace this delta network by their equivalent star network. So now the circuit will look like this, and the value of these resistors will be 12 ohm, 20 ohm and 30 ohm. So now if you see this circuit, in this circuit, these 100 ohm and 20 ohm resistors are connected in series. Likewise, if you see these 30 ohm resistor and a 90 ohm resistors are connected in series. So now the equivalent circuit will look like this. So if you see this equivalent circuit, here these two 120 ohm resistors are connected in parallel. So we can replace these two resistors by their equivalent parallel resistance. And their equivalent parallel resistance will come out to be a 60 ohm. So now the equivalent circuit will look like this. So if you see here, these 60 ohm and 12 ohm resistors are connected in series. So the equivalent resistance between these two node A and B will be nothing but 72 ohms. So in this way, using the delta to star conversion, we can easily solve the circuit problems. So I hope in this video you understood what is delta network and the star network, and how we can convert the delta network into the equivalent star network. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.